What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. Before attempting to tackle the different problems LeetCode has to offer, we are going to explore the most common techniques or approaches used while trying to solve a given problem. One of these approaches goes by binary search. You see, binary search is one of the most fundamental and useful algorithms in computer science. It describes the process of searching for a specific value in an ordered or sorted collection or array. So suppose we have this sorted array of integers, and what we are looking for is the index where the value 25 sits. A trivial solution to this problem could be to iterate over the array in a classic for loop while keeping track of the index. And as soon as the value we are sitting at matches the target value we are looking for, we return with the index. Now, this is a perfectly viable solution for the given problem. However, it runs in linear time. It has an O of n time complexity. Therefore, the time complexity of this algorithm will increase linearly with the number of elements inside the array. Okay, now let's try to find another solution to this problem. What if we were to start at the middle element instead of starting at the first element? So we can calculate the middle element index like this, and because of the sorted property, we know that all the elements to the left of this element are smaller than it, and all the elements to its right are greater than it. Now, all we have to do is check if the element we are looking for, or the target element, is smaller or bigger than the middle element. In this example, the target element is bigger than the one at the middle, which means that the index of the target is 100% located after the middle element. And by doing this one simple comparison, we manage to eliminate half of the elements and indices of the array. If we perform this same comparison again on the new array we obtained, we will be dividing this array by half again, until we find the element we are looking for, or one element remains, the target element we are looking for. Now, before discussing the implementation and the different templates of this algorithm, let's answer why is this algorithm more efficient than the linear solution we previously came up with. You see, binary search is performed by dividing the existing array in half. So, every time we complete one iteration, the remaining size is reduced to the half of the existing part. So, in the first iteration, n becomes n over 2, then it becomes n over 4, and so on, till it finds the element or till the size becomes 1. This can be written as n over 2 to the power k equals 1, k being the number of operations required to find our target, or in other words, the complexity. You can see the mathematical proof of the complexity in front of you, which leads to a logarithmic complexity, or a big O of log base 2 of n, n being the number of elements in our collection. I'll just leave it to this, as we previously demonstrated this several times throughout previous videos. Okay, now to implement the binary search algorithm, our method will need to be provided with a sorted array. So if it isn't sorted, you have to sort it first. And of course, we'll need to know the target we are looking for. The next step is to define the boundaries of the array we will be searching in. At first, we will start off with 0 and length minus 1, as we want to search in the whole array at the beginning. In the first iteration, we will calculate the middle index and compare its value to both our boundaries. So, if the element located at the mid is bigger than the target, then our target must be located in the left part of the array. Thus, we will have to shrink our boundaries to reflect this by moving the right index to the middle minus 1. By doing this, we eliminated all the elements that are in the right half of the array. Similarly, if the target was bigger than the element at the middle, meaning it is located in the right part of the array, then we will have to eliminate the left part by setting the left index to be equal to the middle index plus 1. Finally, if that element equals the target we are looking for, then all we have to do is return the index we found it on, because that's what we are looking for, and this index is the middle index. After updating the left and right indices, what we have to do is reiterate over the new array defined by these indices until we find the value we are targeting, or until we compare it to all the elements without finding it, meaning that the element was not found in the array. You see, the implementation you see here is the classic and most basic implementation of binary search. At each step, we are checking to see if the target element was found, and if we reach the end, then the element was not found. Now, what if the array we had at the beginning allowed duplicates? Let's see what happens. When we apply this implementation on such an array, as you can see, the index returned does store the target we are looking for, but it is just one of the possible indices. What if we want to find, using binary search, the first and last position of that element? How do we find the 9 and the 12 in this example by using binary search only? Let's start with the first position, or the left bound of the target duplicate number. To find this number, the trick is to never return a value while inside the loop or iterations, but instead it is to keep updating the left and right boundaries until they both converge and are equal to the left bound we are looking for. To exit the while loop as soon as the left and right bounds are equal, we need to update the exit condition of the loop as well to be strictly smaller instead of smaller and equal. Okay, so our code until now looks like this. But you see, there is a problem in the if statements we have. What if at some point our middle was pointing to the lower bound of the target, which is the value we are looking for? In this implementation, we will set the right bound to be mid minus 1 and we will totally skip our result. So, the right element can be part of our solution, and to avoid skipping it, we simply set right to be equal to mid instead of mid minus 1. After we finish our iteration, the first occurrence of the target element should be stored inside the left and right indices as they are equal, so all we have to do is check if that element actually existed in the array, and if that's the case, we return it. Now, concerning the right bound of the duplicate target number we are looking for, its implementation will be pretty similar to what we just did for the left bound. However, this time, the left index is the one that should be part of our result set. Therefore, the equals comparison is inversed. So, if the target is bigger or equal than the mid value we are currently checking, then left is updated to mid. Okay, if we apply this implementation as is on the array we have, we will reach a point in our iterations where the left variable is equal to 12 and the right variable is equal to 13. And that's it, we just got ourselves in an infinite loop, as the code will indefinitely enter the first if statement and neither the left or right variable will be updated anymore. Our while loop condition will never be met. To fix this, we have to change our while loop condition to compare the element next to the left one with the right one. After exiting the loop, the left and right variables will not be equal as we had before. Therefore, we will have to check which one of them is the target we are looking for and return that value if it exists. The comparison is done in a way to prioritize the right bound, of course, as we are looking for the last possible occurrence. Okay, to recap, we made use of three binary search templates, and let me tell you that 99% of binary search problems that you will see online will fall into one of these three templates. All of them are logarithmic in time and constant in space. To really grasp them, you should practice identifying when to use binary search in problems and see which template applies to different search conditions. And that is exactly what we will do in the upcoming videos of this series. As for today, and while trying to explain binary search, we managed to solve two LeetCode code problems, to which I'll leave the link down in the description below. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.